Hi, my name is Nicole, and I'll be reading you a bedtime story today, which is called The Very Hungry Caterpillar.
The Very Hungry Caterpillar, which is Chinese and English, by Eric Clarke. For my sister, Krista. In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf.
在月光下，一粒小卵躺在一片叶上。
One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up and pop out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar.
一个星期天的早晨，温暖的太阳升起来了。不，从卵里钻出来了一个又小又非常饥饿的毛毛虫。
He started to look for some food.
他开始寻找食物。
On Monday, he ate through one apple, but he was still very hungry.
星期一，他吃穿了一个苹果，但他还是饿。
On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but he was still very hungry.
星期二，他吃穿了两个梨，但他还是饿。
On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still very hungry.
星期三，他吃穿了三个李子，但他还是饿。
On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still very hungry.
星期四，他吃穿四颗草莓，但他还是饿。
On Friday, he ate through five oranges, but he was still very hungry.
星期五，他吃穿了五个橙，但他还是饿。
On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese.One slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one slice of watermelon. That night, he had a stomach ache.
星期六，他吃穿了一块巧克力蛋糕，一只蛋筒冰淇淋，一条酸黄瓜，一片瑞士奶酪，一片意大利咸肉肠，一只棒棒糖，一块樱桃馅饼，一根香肠，一个小蛋糕，和一片西瓜。那天晚上，他肚子痛了。
The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf, and after that, he felt much better.
第二天又是星期天了。毛毛虫吃穿了一片美丽的树叶子，后来他感到好多了。
Now, he wasn't hungry anymore, and he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar.
现在，他再不饿了。 它也不再是一条小毛毛虫了，它是一条又大又胖的毛毛虫了。
He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. Then he nibbled a hole in the cocoon, pushed his way out, and dun dun dun.
他盖了一所小房子，叫做虫茧，把自己包起来。他在里面住了2个多星期，然后他把虫茧咬破了一个洞，从里面钻了出来。
噔噔噔 ！He was a beautiful butterfly.
他就是一只美丽的蝴蝶。
The end.
好了，故事讲完了。Good night.
Good night.